looking at all the people sitting outside.
testified in the presence of this company to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony. Marriage is an honorable estate, instituted of God, blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ, amended by the Apostle Paul to be honorable among all men. It is not therefore to be entered into lightly, unadvisedly, but reverently, soberly, and in the fear of God. Kevin, do you understand, and are you willing to make a lifelong commitment tonight? Wendi, do you understand, and are you willing to make a lifelong commitment tonight? Who gives this bride and holy matrimony? Join your right hand.
Honored the
celebration by his presence at the wedding feast in Cana of Galilee, and chose this very beautiful relationship as a figure of a union between himself and his church. Paul the Apostle commends it as a worthy institution, essential for social order, human one in all the concerns of this present life. You, Kevin, you, Wendy, having come to me signifying your desire to be formally united in marriage, be assured of this, that there's no legal, no moral, no religious barriers in this proper union this evening. I command you now to give heed to the question I now ask you. Kevin, in taking the woman that you hold by your right hand to be your lawful and wedded wife, do you promise to love and cherish her, to honor and sustain her in sickness as in health, in poverty as well as in wealth, and be true to her in all things till death alone shall part you? Do you promise? Wendy, in taking the man that holds you by the right hand to be your lawful and wedded husband, do you promise to love, cherish, to honor him and sustain him in sickness as well as in health, in poverty as well as in wealth, and be true to him in all things till death alone shall part you? Do you promise?
What words could I use to describe how I feel when I'm near you? What song could I sing that would let you hear the music in my heart? What life could I live that would even come close to the one I lived for you? I will love you till the end of time and more. I will hold you, I fear. What light should ever shine as brightly as your eyes? What priceless work of art could compare to the beauty I find in you? And what greater gift could there possibly be than the love given to me? I will love you till the end of time and more, and I will hold you, our spirits will soar. And I will need you in a thousand years of
has been used to seal important covenants. Earliest rings are found in the tombs of ancient Egypt. Ancient Romans thought the roundness of the ring represented eternity. Within it, a wedding ring symbolizes that a man and woman are united forever. Kings gave their rings to their trusted servants, and then the wearer actually had the power of the king. Joseph's finger replaced the ring of Pharaoh, given power over all of Egypt, found in Genesis, 41st chapter. The golden circle of the ring, made of the finest substance known to man, that symbolizes the prestige and a token of your love for each other. It's the ideal qualities of a marital estate. Kevin, you'll take these rings and place them. Words after me. With this ring, I do wed. All my worldly treasures, I share with you. Wendi, the roundness of the spring, the never-ending love that you have for Kevin, the finest substance known to man, so should you, your love be for Kevin. Place it on his finger and repeat after me. With this ring, I do wed, and all my worldly treasures I share with you. Let's all join our hearts in prayer at this time as we thank God for this couple as they united their lives together. Father, we pause this evening and thank you for the grace that brings human hearts into the bonds of love like that of divine love. I'd ask today that you would grant Kevin and Wendi tie their bind as a servant, and may their love grow stronger through the passing years. May they trust each other in perfect confidence, and together may they trust you for guidance and help in the path ahead. Father, we all ask that you would prosper them in the temporal things according to your purposes and grace, and give them a full measure of spiritual favor, that they may be found triumphant in faith in their everlasting kingdom. We ask these things in Christ's name. Amen. As for much then, Kevin, and you, Wendi, having covenanted together according to the teachings of the Scripture and the laws of this state, and as the minister of the gospel, the power given to me by the state of Texas, I now pronounce you husband and wife. And what God has joined together, let not any man put asunder. Yes, God. I take great privilege this evening. Thank you.
Come on, Wendy. Oh. Look at each other.
Get all the single young ladies over here on this side grouped up.